Ja, hallihallo und herzlich willkommen zurück zu Let's Play The Stanley Parable, beziehungsweise willkommen zu einer Bonusfolge, in der ich wie versprochen den Speedrun zeige, zumindest eine Version des Speedruns. Man kann das wohl auf mehreren Wegen irgendwie schaffen. Ich habe das auf diese Art und Weise geschafft, wie ihr es dann gleich seht. Und wundert euch nicht, was das für ein komischer Raum ist, der dort an Stanleys Büro anknüpft. Den erreicht man im Prinzip nur durch Neustarten und dann wird der random irgendwann mal erzeugt. Dann gelangt ihr viel schneller in das Boss-Office und von dort aus kann man dann noch abkürzen, indem man auf Tische klettert und von dort aus auf die Verbindungsstücken springt und ach, alles Mögliche. Beim ersten Mal habe ich das hier nicht wirklich geschafft. Die Zeit hat letztlich trotzdem gereicht. Und ja, viel Spaß damit. Das ist relativ kurz und unspektakulär. Und es kommt noch eine Bonusfolge, dazu dann aber später mehr. Also viel Spaß und tschüss.
All of his co-workers were gone. What could it mean? Stanley decided to... When Stanley came to a set of two open doors, he entered the door on his left. Yet there was not a single person here either. Feeling a wave of disbelief, Stanley decided to go up to his boss's office. Coming to a staircase, Stanley walked upstairs to his boss's office. Here's the door, just go. Stanley walked straight ahead through the large door that read Mind Control Facility. The lights rose on an enormous room packed with television screens. What horrible secret did this place hold? Stanley thought to himself. Did he have the strength to find out? Now the monitors jumped to life, their true nature revealed. Each bore the number of an employee in the building, Stanley's co-workers. The lives of so many individuals reduced to images on a screen. And Stanley, one of them, eternally monitored in this place where freedom meant. This mind control facility, it was too horrible to believe. It couldn't be true. Had Stanley really been under someone's control all this time? Was this the only reason he was happy with his boring job? That his emotions had been manipulated to accept it blindly? No. He refused to believe it. He couldn't accept it. His own life in someone else's control? Never! It was unthinkable, wasn't it? Was it even possible? Had he truly spent his entire life utterly blind to the world? But here was the proof, the heart of the operation. Controls labeled with emotions, happy or sad or content. Walking, eating, working, all of it monitored and commanded from this very place. And as the cold reality of his past began to sink in, Stanley decided... Blackness and a rising chill of uncertainty. Was it over? Yes! He had won! He had defeated the machine! Unshackled himself from someone else's command. Freedom was mere moments away! And yet, even as the immense door slowly opened, Stanley reflected on how many puzzles still lay unsolved. Where had his co-workers gone? How had he been freed from the machine's grasp? What other mysteries did this strange building hold? But as sunlight streamed into the chamber, he realized none of this mattered to him, for it was not knowledge or even power that he had been seeking, but happiness. Perhaps his goal had not been to understand, but to let go. No longer would anyone tell him where to go, what to do, or how to feel. Whatever life he lives, it will be his. And that was all he needed to know. It was perhaps the only thing worth knowing. Stanley stepped through the open door. Stanley felt the cool breeze upon his skin, the feeling of liberation, the immense possibility of the new path before him. This was exactly the way, right now, that things were meant to happen. And Stanley was happy.